Eskrima, the indigenous fighting art of the Philippine Islands, also known as Arnis or Kali. It is one of the fastest and deadliest martial arts in the world. Although commonly perceived as a stick fighting art, it is just one component of a complete fighting system. It includes a mastery of short and long-bladed weapons, as well as a variety of empty hand techniques. The spiritual home of this Filipino fighting art is the island of Cebu. Located in the center of the Philippine archipelago, Cebu has been a trading center and a confluence of cultures since ancient times. Cebu is also home to some of the greatest Eskrima masters in the world. The history of Eskrima in Cebu began in the 13th century when the Srivijayan Empire from Java ruled most of Southeast Asia. They were overthrown by the Majapahit Empire from Eastern Java and were forced to flee north to the Philippine Islands. The Srivijayan refugees settled in the central part of the archipelago in what is now known as the Visayan Islands. The Srivijayans were a warrior culture and were said to have brought the technology of forged blades to the islands. When the Spanish came in the 16th century, these Visayan warriors were already practicing a systemized form of warfare against other tribes. In April 27, 1521, Spanish explorer Ferdinand Magellan met his demise at the hands of these Visayan warriors in the Battle of Mactan. The Spanish returned in greater numbers and with the aid of superior technology, eventually subjugated the islands. After 300 years of Spanish colonial rule, there was a growing fear of rebellion. The Spanish prohibit the Filipinos from practicing Eskrima. The Eskrima masters went underground and began training in secret, using sticks, bolos, and knives, since they are readily available to civilians. Eskrimadores soon made stick fighting an art form unto itself. No longer limited to blade-based linear strikes, the emphasis was now on speed and accuracy. Using the stick, meant that attacks could come from more angles and at closer ranges.
Traditional linear is when you strike, it's like a blade. It's a blade pattern strikes, eh? It's like a blade. While the snap wrist, the flicking strike, curving strike is abaniko is part of them. It's Wittig. It's curving strike. The advantage of this is even if he blocks the strike, it still circles around the defense. Hits him. He blocks the strike, it circles around the defense.
Nanay mo napita, igo ko na. Bisa kung sama pa niya, may igo ka na siya, anak. Igo. Pagana. Igo. Pagana ko, go push up. Igo. Pagana ko, go push up. Igo, weapon.
Too dangerous to attempt with bladed weapons, Eskrimadors could now perform disarming maneuvers, of which they have an endless repertoire.
So, ang mahito na ko yun eh, nagbunin na ako, gurita-gurita yun. Mukulay ako, ba't pa ako? Iyan niyo ko.
Iyan yung kuhaon. Kuha ako muna. Tumasin yung kuhaon.
In the early days, each tribe or clan practiced its own system of eskrima. These were closely guarded secrets, which were passed on from one generation to the next.
Ang akong uyuan na si Arsenio Kamurnay, mo'to'y eskrimador, wapangan li ni Gulapunti, wapatusay nga, eskrima lang. Ano, hangtod nga, nakatko na akong amahan, tinuluan sa akong uyuan, akong uyuan.
My grandfather and his brothers been practicing the art since 1890.
Watch how the hit was gained using the single and double slashes or the half slash.
Unsa ang eskrima tay sa abaniko ni? Yung ana raman akong buhan niya, pumaypay. Yung ana. Dat ako ng gidibilog kay mo may bidas akong amahan. Since nga pagkahibaw din ako eskrima.
Kanyetes, my father, he learned nakat-on sila from my father and my uncles and from other masters. But when they meet with the sabidras, they found the two sabidras to have very good technique. That their eskrima was superior. They adopted the kanyetes as their first few students.
Kami ang 8 brothers, akong 7 brothers, and both eskrima. O yan, di ba sila gusto mabiyahin ko? Yapin ko ko nila. O nga sa silang practice, tuwa, kuyo ko. O gano'n yung mga apoy sa mga magsima doon, mga master, tuwa ko dito. Dano lang yung gusto kong magawa.
Kato akong papa, pwede mo ito ibalin ni Angro kayo sa left. Nakusgan mo ito akong papa. Kaya kay school lamang po si Idiox muna eh, kung mga manghod. School lamang po sila po. So, ako gi primero, ako gi badibadya sa mga amahan yun.
Ako pa pa, atlet siya siya, gusto siya mga aran. Mga martial arts, before nga, noon, niya, nana sa iyang amahan, nana sila yung mga dambil at una. Kaya, kay magbiyahe man siya, ato mga lay-lay lugar, si Kihor, abot siya mga Bicol, mga isla-isla. Katon siya mga eskrima, nagsagay mga eskrima, tawag niya, sumbra, sukiti, sumbra mo nang magpayo, payo kayo. Sumbra means shadow. Kado ano, payo.
Ang show sa ko, after ko mahal, mga eskrimador. Ang show sa ko na, mga eskrimador. Lasa mo dugo.
Thank you. crazy because you can just lose this. When spicy at the side, and black, and the right as well.
Di ko man apungan. Malubag man ko. So, yung tanaw niyang kuha niya, ibuhian ko na. So, kawat ko siya. So, muna ni, nikawat na. So, ano na. Counter siya, ni-counter niya. Ingon ko.
So, barong ko na ko siya. Ito ko na judo ko, sumbaw siya, papa. Mag-iatan.
Magana niya. Tanaw sitwasyon ko, please, no? Hamang flow niya, padong dere. So, ang flow na ko, padong sa dere, padong sa ko dere.
Pagpasok mo, balik ko na. Balik
mo. Ito ang flow na ko. Di ko siya mo against na ko dere. Eh, kung gana ko against siya, against. Against, tuloy ko sa kumit ko. Lubag ko siya nga rin.
Regime was established in Cebu. The Americans encouraged the Filipinos to practice the right. So everybody, you know, all masters, grandmasters, they came out in the open, and that's how they started. So in 1920, with the Savitra uncle and nephew, they lead the group of Sumadors, they formed the first ever martial art club in the Philippines, itong Labangon Fishing Club. Labangon Fishing Club disbanded in 1930. Then 12 masters revived. Spearheaded by my father, they formed Duciparis.
In 1932, pagkatukod sa Duciparis, ginawa ito nila para gawin ang rivalry. Lain-lain ko pa rin ang lain ng club lang. Isig-isig na ako, isig-isig na ako, mayroon niya mo. Ito yun lang, ato ni, we have to unify all our clubs to avoid rivalry.
It seems the idea came spontaneously.
They called the Duciparis the best, the name on the 12 fighting bodyguard of Emperor Charlemagne of France. 7, 8, 9. Each member has his own style. Teaching his own style. They have this larga mano, others medio largo, medium range, others corto. In corto, they have different styles. And there were masters who were only good in the hands. There were masters who were good only in knife fighting. And there were who specialized only in long blade or bolo fighting.
The perennially secretive masters now shared their techniques with one another. This exchange of ideas brought the fighting art of Eskrima to another level. Grandmaster Filemon, Momoy Cañete, was perhaps the most respected Eskrimador of his era. He served as the chief instructor and guiding figure of Doce Pares until his death in 1995.
Mabuti ko kaya sa mga namubase. Mabuti ako na interview ko siya ba? Sa dami tanan. Kasi may mga apil mo nene. Siya may mga uls na mo. May spaya na mo. Apil mo nene. Kaya maya nene para sa prepes. O mo siya. Kami hukop sa tanan.
Watch closely now the various movements of Professor Filemon Cañete. They're using a wooden dagger.
Si Momoy Cañete, kung panahon nato niya, motor siya ay most popular sa armies o sa eskrima. Pero ang iya yung most popular yun niyang fungal system, pero yung hispanda ay daga. Sword with ban niya, katong iyang bullwhip, na tiguba. Niya, ang iyang system, bitawag niya armies eskrima San Miguel. Time.
Fighting and pain fighting. advanced strike. Watch closely.
Mamoy, as a leader, is very, very honest, especially to his boys. He cares for his boys.
Mugis to siya, pinakamaayo gibisag sa unsang paagi, kumbat, arnes, kuansya, sparidaga, mugis to siya, noon yun kayo.
Black and fire, double kill committee. There's a strike, double strike, and the hook. He was trying to cut the professor's head, Garotti, but look what happened.
In the olden days, escrimadores were known to be healers as well. They believed in charms and amulets known as anting-anting and the orasyon, a spoken prayer.
90% sa mga escrimador na ito doon ay words of power.
Ang katos tatay na ito yung orasyon siya, pati pagpanambal. Pagkabi ito sa mga ji, na siya papilang yung itamdan ba? Ito ang isuot niya mga parte pagpanambal.
Tapos Papa, he is not an ordinary person. He possesses also a talisman. He is a talisman from doon natin siya anting-anting. Until his death, iyan ang gida. At iswa dito siya ordinary ng tao para nako asisan. At ilan natin siya maswari na tirahan ng armas wa kabuto. Oo, wa ni fail. Wa agad isa ito pa. Doon na dito siya protection ba?
Kini muna gitawang habak or amulet sa English or anting-anting. Ang unang tawag ni habak kay ani ibakos mo niya sa di sa hawak. Mabuhat ni, doon na may kusog. Una makusgan ka. Ikadawa maabti ka. Ikatulod, di ka maigo. Humigo ka mga lindi kasakitan.
Sword ni, shield ni.
Checking is to monitor, control, blank your attacking weapon with your free hand. When you strike, blank, there's always a checking hand.
May mo, agdaw na po dito eh. Kaya naaman ni siya firme. Bisag piyong nga balin ako, bisag asa pa siya dagat. May bawa nga niya mo kay basing on sense sa mundo.
Any object nga mo mupakgam sa akong pamatay nga kamot. Mone, mo'y. Mo'y mo dispanta.
Okay, this is how I check. I check you there doing what you feel. Where you go next? Down. You know why he goes down? You know why he goes down? Because I influence his brain to go down. Why? Because of my check. Look at how I conduct the check. This little finger make him feel that there is resistance. Pull back a little. See? There is resistance. You go up. There is resistance. What is an area no resistance? That is where I want him to go.
That is the area apparently open for target.
May mo black phone ako siya pag wala niya. Wala ko bana ko. Hindi niya makatag. Buko siya. Puto ako pirmi. Always nina ako pirmi. May kung mabante siya, mingo siya. Sari lo. Nga pirmi.
So when I do like this, I check automatically he knows. There is resistance, there is resistance, there is no resistance. When he goes near to it, no. No, because my check just turned to the pellet. He cannot see. Go down. There is. But there is no resistance here. So when it goes like that, we attack here? No. I can just do it. In 1948, 1949, 1950, up to 1952, Ducie Parish was rocked by a lot of intrigues and jealousies. Not only among masters, not so much. It was among the followers of the different masters. Each were trying to outdo each other, that my style, my master style, better than yours. The group mainly in against each other with the group of Grandmaster Anshung Bakun and the group of Grandmaster my uncle, Kakoy Kanyete. And there were other groups, minor groups, but these two groups were just, they really hated each other too much jealousy.
Grandmaster Venancio, Anshung Bakun, a former pupil of Lorenzo Saavedra, was considered one of the best escrimadores in the Doce Pares Club. His skill won him many followers. Among them were Delfin Lopez and Timoteo Maranga, members of the Cebu City Police Force, who were known as formidable fighters.
Kato Delfin Lopez lang, dako ka ito. Si Maranga, dako ka ito. Yung anong nagpatoon man niya, Arnes.
Pag ito niya, pagkikita niya ang Anshung, piting gamay sa.
One time, Anshung Bakun, dunay nanghagan ni Anshung Bakun. Diristalisa ito gidua. Dua kabuk grote, maragug sungkod god. Bunal, nilihay sa Anshung Bakun. Oto, pag-igo, pag-sunod bunal, pag doon may grote niya, tag-as patistanan. Isagang Anshung Bakun. Mungin man kita. Pag-inabang! Kung ako sa dere, gisin sa dagan god.
Early 1952, Bakun got out of Ducie Pares with Lopez, Maranga in tow, then they put up their old club, Balintawak.
Named after the downtown side street where they held practice sessions, Anshung Bakun and his followers develop the Balintawak style of a screamer.
Kendo si Pero si Anato, doa man ka garote, maganay. Amaraman, amara, ana, ana. Hangtod nga garote o hanting, puntay daga na, puntay daga. Yung una-una ng ansyo nga, mita ko glain ini. Mag-imbinto ko glain mo to nga, one stick na lang.
Balintawak fighters favored a brutal and efficient close-quarter fighting style, more suitable to their urban environment.
Yakin ni siya, ipukpuk ni, piripukpuk, bunal ni, sumbag ni, siko ni. Yakin ni siya, mga oras ni. Managpa na, mupus and pull na. Kini musiko na ni siya. Muna ang giimbinto ni Ansyong.
An intense rivalry soon formed between the Doce Pares and Balintawak clubs. They began to pit their most able fighters against each other in no-holds-barred challenge fights.
They call it the Hoy Cotodo or Thief matches, because every time you spar, it's like a duel. You have no headgear, no protector, and it's full contact fighting.
Dueling was a long-standing tradition for Eskrimadors. When there were no wars to fight or conflicts to settle, they would seek out one another to test their skill. It was a common practice for the duelists to sign injury waivers before they fought. Severe injuries and even deaths were known to have occurred.
Oh, sabuto siya nga. Ipilitan kitang duha, magsabuto nga magduwa ta. Ana, pero surrender la ubi ka guanta.
Kung sabay credit ana ba? Kung sabay ka niya, may taging una aki kwarta, wa, git, nga lagi ma, dungog ra.
Mas mayo pa na nako, saya na to.
Gidungog ka sa libon, natuong ka.
You're not a scrimmador, you're not willing to fight. Nana mana.
This dueling tradition was brought to Hawaii and California by Filipino migrant workers as far back as the 1920s.
Eskrima stylists, all the masters before, they were just satisfied if they can beat their opponents in that match.
Grandmaster Inting Karin of Doce Pares was a reputed veteran of numerous Juego Todo matches. In one famous incident, Inting Karin was attacked by four knife-wielding assailants and survived.
Incident ato, ang yan ko pa rin tingmuros while the ongoing ng pista sa Mabulo, minus papa ko sa night fighting. Pati yung amigo, si Pangawa Usugat, ibukod to sa mga parinti sa tag-iya sa hindi na tindahan. Pagbukod na, niagi niya, di pag-agi niya, lain man to, kung mukhang siya man eh. Pagkong siya man eh, ni Silo yung amigo siya, may gato ba? Niya na ang to'y dang na ipirmi. Doon ka, kapit, kamog. Doon na lang siya, bangko, luyo. Bangko, diba? Bangko sa unang nga, suligod. Igo isa nga rin mo itong tumba. So, pag tumba niya, tiwasan ka siya. Yung snap, hansak siya. Ah! Antun. Pass out, yung check eh. Ano ba naman siya? Itong yung kwan nila eh. Pass out siya. Nida siya sa morgue. While ready for operation niya siya, paibawa na among mga kwan. Na, may radio sa unang paibawa na. Niyagi na Yuling, Kanyete, Papa ni Kwan. Saan na? Sinting kare mo, nag-ihaya na dia. Yan, suwag. Init po man, doon na po may sense of life. So, init po man eh. Ang suway nga ito, gita. Ano itong pangay tubig si Papa, nirtabir siya.
In the main streets of Cebu, the knife is the most common weapon. Eskrima knife fighting techniques are considered some of the best in the world.
Diferensya kay kini og lupi ka diha na igo na ang amo diri diha
hey hakot na siya
Unlike the Chinese and Japanese martial arts, which were originated and practiced by monks and nobility, Eskrima comes from more humble origins.
Kaya Eskrima God was known to be the art of the poor people, was known to be the art of the bum, because some members of the parish, they were criminal elements inside. They were, because they come from the very poor segment of society. Dulce Pares was just based in San Nicolas, in Pasir District, for many years.
The Pasir San Nicolas District of Cebu was a known breeding ground for many famous escrimadores.
Kining area, labi na sumuas Pasir, daghan yung mga tao mo notorious kaya diha. Kagadong nagtrabaho na spear, nagtrabaho na sa isdaan. Ang ilang kusog, may puhunan nila. Niya kung doon ay mga labi na ganang union, sa Lake Hoaon, either himons lang sa striker o himons lang sa cab. Ngayon na ang life niya. Ngayon ka notorious nga, number one notorious sa Cebu, ang Pasil. Di ako nagdakbo.
The image of an escrimador was that of a gunfighter, willing to accept any challenge simply for bragging rights.
Ang kanyang bilang tawag, basta walang sangang makadungog nga. Dauton ang among ngan, at to na yung ngan to. Ano, pangitaon, rin na mo.
Bukal pa kayo dugugod, nagtanuan bugod.
Kami, ako, Dr. Marapaw, Winnie de la Rosa, akong bangot, si Idi, si Muni, Mio de la Rosa. Mugod ito'y fighter, yun. Ang katulang kang Dr. Marapaw, kaya doon naman siya yung mga lodgers. Pagtawag na sa telepono, bungkag laging practice club. Kaya doon naman ang hagis, nangagto gamitanan.
Oh, why good ko?
Oh,
In the early 1970s, Filipino martial arts began emerging into the consciousness of the martial arts world. Doce Pares was invited to perform a series of demonstrations in the United States.
Yun ay yung primero nito. Onya kami sunod, tumitakoy, Bodokista, kami sunod.
We arrived America in early 75. Di pa dimusit ko nila dyan sa, this is documented by Los Angeles, in the school of Dami Santo, group of Bruce Lee, Filipino Cali Academy. Pabunod ko to, so, sila, what's your style? I don't know what do you mean by style. Huwag doon may kalimutan itong sa style, Doce Pares. Dito naman sila, we just call your style, Doce Pares style. Dito na, makindong style kayo. Here, we identify pa rin. Ang Takoy, he uses Kutokobada. Kawitikwiti. Momoy is San Miguel style, ang Kurturina. My father's Larga Mano. Kaya kung Papa Long Range man. So we identify it by personality.
Pag ito na mo, the demand quickened.
Can you see this paredada? Knife, blade? Said, you're surprised. You practically know everything. I said, don't know. That's what you're doing back home. Para mo din ariyo man. To them, they're surprised kay dito good. Ukurto ka kurso dyan. Lagamano ka dyan. Namar gina. Huwag kami kay kanan man.
The art spread fast. Tungkol kay bago para sa mga tao. They talk to it.
Lutong nga kayo ba? Akong iinandan sila. The best way to promote an art is to make it into sporting event. It's like boxing, they have sports, football, basketball. But how come? In every time we spar, we kill each other.
No parents in the right mind will allow their kids to study with us when they know a week later somebody will challenge them to fight.
We want to reach out to all corners of the world. We have to band together, civilized ourselves, civilized our way of sparring. That's the only thing.
So I form a committee to draft the tournament rules. In
when we have the rules, we cannot fight because we don't have equipment. So I designed the headgear, the kitten, the gloves, the design, 1976.
My gears were so thin, not too amply protected. The body gear was only to here. And sometimes they fight without gloves. I put in some gloves there, but some fighters, they're not used to it. They forgot. They fight, oh, I have no gloves. Stop. When we started holding this formal tournament, collision was always full. Because people thought that they were out to kill each other.
Pag championship ko, mga tao ko, doon na good sa ringside. Layo naman to, ng lingkod, wala na. Puno ang kulisyon.
People thought it was just like the old Goy Gotudo, it matches. No, but they found it out that we have gears. We have protected gears.
After the first national tournaments were held, Escrimadores gradually shifted their focus from death matches towards organized competition. The bitter rivalries, which marked the age of Juego Todo, were coming to an end.
Yeah.
The World Eskrima Cali Arnis Federation, the largest governing body for the promotion of Filipino martial arts through sports, holds the world championships biennially, with every second championship returning to Cebu. The fighting art of Eskrima is now practiced all over the world.
My name is Heather Turnbull, and I'm from Toronto, Canada.
Kim Andrea Murdal from Norway.
Ferenc Vanko from Hungary.
Sarah Charles, I'm from Great Britain.
Justin Lemke, I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, USA.
Andrea Cittadelli, and from Italy.
I started when I was about 14, doing Eskrima, and I just fell in love with it. It was the school I started at, I did karate, and then once I got my coordination up, I started doing Eskrima, and I felt like it was just a whole other world of new things that opened up to me.
It's exciting, it looked fun. Because I do a multi-system, it means I can do all sorts of things. It's not just stick fighting, I do some knife work, you know, some empty hands. There's a lot to learn, and you don't have to be good at everything.
In Eskrima, we can have everything. The really fighting techniques, or just the coordination, or just having fun.
Perché è una disciplina marziale particolarmente interessante per la difesa personale ed è uno sport nuovo nel panorama marziale.
It's adrenaline. Once you learn and understand Filipino martial arts, it's very universal. It's an art within an art.
You look for technique as well as combinations, equally blocking or defending. It looks like they're just pounding away at people, but there are blocking patterns, drills, using abanico, which is higher strikes, lower footwork. You should be moving offline. If they're pounding away, it's very, very difficult to see the number of points, but essentially it's not just how hard you hit, but how many hits that you get in.
And I think of Filipinos as leading the way, and I've been really impressed. Yeah, I think because they're taught to pick up a stick from so high, you know? It's just natural, it's just someone that comes naturally to it. It's inbred, you know? They're very fast with their hands.
Oh, every Filipino fighter is very, very, very good. They are very quick, very strong. They fight from the heart. It's really, really good.
Our guru or head coach came to the Philippines to train with many of the grandmasters, and so we were inspired this time to come earlier. So for us, this is an opportunity to come back to the home of our niece and learn from the best. But you'll see from the results here that the Canadians and many other countries are now beating some of the Filipinos.
There might be technological transfer there from us to America, because Americans and the Europeans, when they train hard.
If you want to get anywhere here, you really have to learn. I mean, you really have to work at it. We don't necessarily have to do that back home, because our people in school, they go, you know, 7-8 hours a day and, you know, homework. And that's it. Then they go play basketball, play baseball, go to martial arts schools, do other things. We have time to do that. Whereas here, Filipinos, just in education, they have to devote a large percentage of their growing up just to education. They don't have the time to devote to martial arts studies.
Once the foreigner learned the Filipino martial art, they do it 24/7. You know, with us, I know life. I grew up here in Manila. I know it's hard to focus on martial arts.
There are a lot of people in the Philippine martial arts, Filipinos that have migrated, people from Filipino families that migrated and then they were born later, other countries, Filipinos that have left and gone, you know, and started teaching in other countries. I think there's a lot of people who have had a chance to catch up and pass a lot of people that are still stuck here, because we have more opportunity to train and practice at home. Weather conditions, nutrition is better, people have a chance to be a little healthier. We have a lot more advantages for people to learn.
Scream is still spreading far and wide. It is still spreading far and wide. Ang kuan lang, ang tournament lang, dire sa Cebu, sa atong nakita lang, di na kayo intense ang competition. But it is spreading far and wide.
Mas popular karon dit sa abroad, dili dire sa ato. Ngari sa ato, is not popular anymore.
Ang mga second generation, ano po kayo interest? Mabta ni kay ngong ko nga di ni maayo nagkanamo ko wag tama mas ni kuya na pa ang mga foreign arts martial arts kaysa eskrima. Ang eskrima suppose ato kita nang amumahon ba kay ato ako ni gud dili ko ni ingon nga sa lain kita nagbugnaan ni ang Pilipino noon sa gawas nga ato ako ni ya ato ini nga mumahon ta nya wa may interest ang mga tao
kung way maning kamot ini way barog ini pag promote kining atong gugma sa atong sa atong earnest sa atong Pilipino siyas mamatay na siya ulit atong kamatayon kay mawa raman.
This is the best time. If they have not recognized the significance, the beauty of the art, it is high time for them to realize now.
Kaning mga eskrimador nga akong ilan na kuna na ako, karoon ako muna mo sila mga unsung hero sa atong nasyon, sa atong Pilipinas. Kaya kung wala pa na sila, dili ni maila ni Pilipinas na may laki sila sa martial art.
Me and my brothers were called that we were born with a stick in our hand. So, it's part of my life.
Ang masir na ko sa ang hibawaan ako ngadto sa mga katawhan nga pamaagi ilang ko anong bang makatabang kun silang kogalingon parte sa depensa nya makahunahon na sila na ko wala ko nga mo ni gatudlo na ko mo ni ana
ini deh dah saya bodoh ko dito kapulat. Ang sukaron di mo gupulang sirma, kundi formal para na ko, part of my life.
Why retire ni? Huh? Masa bang retire mo, di ko na mo tire? Di ko na mo tire, di ka retire.
Bisa pa mo tanaw ako nila niya ni maabot ang panahon dili na sila mo ang kon ako ni tudlo niya na pero sa hilom sa kasing kasing nalipay ko nga ila gid nagigamit hindi na kalimutan ako ni tudlo na na.
kilalan sa atong mga eksoon. Ang kagubot o pagmahal tungod kay gisalikway. Ang uba, gibi-abi-abi.